Good evening. Good evening. I've been working hard on that because I'm used to saying good morning and welcome to Hosanna Lutheran Church. But it definitely is evening, and we are here in the upper room waiting to see what's going to happen next on this Maundy Thursday. Welcome to this time of worship. My name is Pastor Linda Friesen. This worship experience has been a tradition at Hosanna for many, many years, and there's been a three-year pause, and so we are both excited and humbled to be bringing it back tonight. There is an opportunity for you to join us in mission. Perhaps you noticed when you came in there are donation boxes in the back, and also in your bulletin tonight there is a QR code if you can help us out in any way so that together we can live, love, and serve so that all will know Jesus. That is a great opportunity, again, for you to join us. This would be a great time for you to take out your electronic device, go ahead and do it, and then put it on silent so that you don't interrupt either the cast or those people sitting around you. Well, my friends, tonight we do enter this space that we are calling the upper room. While this is a Last Supper reenactment, it is also a worship experience. You will be invited forward during this worship experience to partake in Holy Communion. We serve tonight by a method called intinction, which is simply a fancy way of saying dipping. You will be invited forward, you will receive a piece of bread, and then you will be invited to dip it into a chalice. The chalice is a cup, a split chalice. The dark colored liquid is wine. The lighter colored liquid is a non-alcoholic option. If you need a gluten-free wafer rather than the bread, please just ask, and those are available tonight. Following worship, we ask that you would pause for a time of silent meditation. Think about what happened here tonight. And then as you leave, the cast will be out in the welcome area. There's a brief reception that will happen. There'll be coffee, cookies, water. Go ahead and greet that cast and welcome each other. And then a reminder that the story does not end here in the upper room. Tomorrow night is Good Friday, and we will be right back in this space remembering where we've been and then traveling with Jesus to the cross. We invite you to be part of the crowd on Good Friday. That worship service is also at 7:30 p.m. Then we travel through Silent Saturday, a time to consider what's happened during this Holy Week as we ready our hearts and our heads for Easter celebration, which will be happening down in the Great Hall at 9:30 a.m. So please consider joining us. Let us take a moment to quiet our heads and our hearts as we prepare for this time of worship. Let us pray. Gracious God, as those who strive to follow Jesus in our living and to trust your power in our dying, we gather now to reflect upon the life that ended on a cross. We recognize in ourselves the strengths and the weaknesses of Jesus' disciples. We will see that although they loved him, they disappointed and failed him. And so this night, we gather with these imperfect friends at this last meal, and we are invited into the story. We are humbled, we are honored, and we are inspired by the deep love of Jesus for the world. So, dear Jesus, make us instruments of that love. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let the story begin.
This is the lament of Judas Iscariot, the betrayer. My mind is clear now. At last, all too well, I can see where we all soon will be. If you strip away the myth from the man, you will see where we all soon will be. Start to believe the things they say of you. You really do believe this talk of God is true. And all the good you've done will soon be swept away. You'll be gonna matter more than all the things you said. Listen, Jesus, I don't like what I see. All I ask is that you listen to me. And remember, I've been your right-hand man all along. But you have set them all on fire. They think they found the new Messiah. They'll crush you if they think you're wrong. I remember when this whole thing began. No talk of God, then we called you a man. And believe me, my admiration for you hasn't died. But every word you say today gets twisted round some other way. And they'll crush you if they think you've lied. Nazareth, your famous son, should have stayed a great unknown, like his father carving wood. He'd have made good. Tables, chairs, and oaken chests would have suited Jesus best. He'd have caused nobody harm, no one alarm. Listen, Jesus, don't you care for your race? Don't you see we must keep in our place? We are occupied. Have you forgotten how put down we are? Oh, I am so frightened by this crowd, for we are getting much too loud. I think we've gone a bit too far. Listen, Jesus, to the warning I give. Please remember that I want us to live. But it's sad to see our chances weakening with every hour. All your followers are blind. There's too much heaven on their minds. It was beautiful, but now it's sour. Yes, it's all gone sour. Listen, Jesus. A father and his two young children walk the road to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover. Walking on the road to Jerusalem, the time had come to sacrifice again. My two young children walk beside me on the road. The reason that they came was to watch the Lamb. Daddy, Daddy, what will we see there? There's so much that we don't understand. So I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. And I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. There will be so many in Jerusalem today. We must be sure the Lamb doesn't run away. I told them of Moses and Father Abraham. I said, dear children, watch the Lamb. When we reached the city, I knew something must be wrong. There were no joyful worshipers and no joyful worship songs. I stood there with my children in the midst of angry men. Then I heard the crowd shout out, crucify him. We tried to leave the city, but we couldn't get away. Forced to play a part in the drama we did not want to play. Why upon this day were men condemned to die? Why were we standing there where soon they would pass by? I looked, someone said, even now they come. The first one cried for mercy, the people gave him none. The second one was violent. He was arrogant and loud. I still hear his angry voice screaming at the crowd. But then someone said, "There's Jesus." I scarce believed my eyes. A man so badly beaten that he barely looked alive. Blood poured from his body, from the thorns upon his brow. Running down the cross, falling to the ground. I watched him as he struggled. I watched him as he fell. The cross came down upon his back and the crowd began to yell. In that moment I felt such agony, that moment I felt such loss, till a Roman soldier grabbed my arm and said, you, carry his cross. At first I tried to resist him, but his hand reached for his sword. So I knelt down, I took the cross from the Lord. Place it on my shoulder, we started down the street. The blood he'd been shedding was running down my cheek. They said, they took us to Golgotha, put nails deep in his feet and hands. On the cross I heard him say, "Father, please forgive them." Never have I seen such love in any other eyes. Into thy hands I commit my spirit. He prayed and he died. I stood for what seemed like years. I'd lost all sense of time until I felt two tiny hands holding tight to mine. My children stood there weeping. I heard the oldest say, "Daddy, please forgive us. The lamb ran away." "Daddy, Daddy, what have we seen here? There's so much that we don't understand." So I took them in my arms. We turned, we faced the cross. And I said, "Dear children, watch the Lamb."
Then came the day of unleavened bread, when the Passover lamb must be killed. And then he sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and prepare us the Passover, that we may eat." And they said unto him, "Where would you like us to make the preparations?" And he said unto them, "When you enter into the city, there shall be a man you meet, bearing a pitcher of water. Follow him into the house that he enters. Then say to the man of the house, 'The master says, where is the guest chamber where I shall eat the Passover with my disciples?' And he shall show you a large, furnished upper room. There, make ready."
I think everything is in order. Did you bring the bitter herbs, John?
Yes, here. Where would you like them?
Good. Right here, next to the sauce. The lamb is roasted and ready. So I do hope they arrive on time.
Peter, you fuss as much as Martha. They will be here soon, I am certain.
I don't know.
They were traveling with Jesus through the city, and undoubtedly someone stopped them along the way to ask for the master's help. Be patient, man, and stop pacing. Everything is just as it should be.
No, it's not, John. I'm nervous. I have a feeling a strange foreboding. I mentioned it to my wife last night, and she said, the events in the city are making me upset, and I grant that's part of it. With Jesus helping so many people, and then so many miracles. But when he had the run-in with the temple authorities over the money and selling businesses there, well, they looked at us differently when we go by. Have you noticed?
Yes, what you say is true. But it's the master in his manner, the way he does things and talks lately, that have me so concerned. He talks so much about death and life. And when he said the temple could be destroyed and in 3 days raised up by him, I was at a loss to understand him. And whose death does he mean? His? But what of the kingdom? I always felt he meant to set up his kingdom soon, to throw off the Romans. Heaven knows we've waited a long time for that. Yeah. But if he is put to death.
Death? Death to the master? The Messiah? Not on your life. They'll have to get past me first. I will give up my life for him if they touch one hair on his head.
Easy, man. Next, we'll need the healing hands of the master for you. I understand how you feel. I too would defend him. There seems to be something on his mind lately. That and the way he draws us aside so often to talk about the kingdom and the Father. I don't understand, and yet I feel as if he's waiting for something. Watching and waiting and preparing us for it.
Well, I'm prepared tonight. With the move in this city, I armed myself before I came. See?
Peter, it's unlawful to have a weapon with him.
Say nothing. I hear them coming. Philip. Shalom, brother. So happy to see you. Come in. Andrew, shalom, brother. Come in.
Shalom, John.
Shalom.
Shalom.
Welcome.
Shalom.
Welcome.
Shalom.
Welcome. Shalom.
Find us Simon.
Andrew. Andrew.
Shalom,
shalom,
brother. Come in.
Thomas.
Brother.
How are you, brother?
Come in.
Simon.
Yes, look at all the stuff, right? I know, it's here. You guys, so happy you guys made it.
Peace be with you, Peter. Are all things ready?
Shalom, Master. We have found a room, just as you said, and everything is ready according to the law. Can you guys believe all this food? Yes, look at it.
Peace be with you, John.
Peace be to you, Lord. And peace be to you, my brothers.
Shalom. Shalom.
Master, everything is good.
Where's the roast?
Here, Peter. The woman sent the lamb up with me. And see how well roasted it is?
Why?
And me? As hungry as the Lion of Judah.
You are always hungry, Matthew. I can see why you took up tax collecting before. They eat well, do they not?
They do.
They do.
Here, John. Martha sent along some more unleavened bread. She wanted to be sure we had enough. And Mary sends us her love and best wishes.
Of course.
Mary. Yes, yes. Isn't this awesome? I know.
Shalom.
Yes.
Welcome, brother.
I know. I think we're ready. Lord, everything is ready. Would you take your place in the center? And then John next to Jesus.
Of course, that would make sense.
Over here on this side. And then Judas over here next to John. And then Andrew. Simon, and Thomas at the end, and then Matthew, next to the roast, I guess, other James, Philip, Bartholomew, and Thaddeus at the end. Do we have enough places?
Thank you for being
so good. Then I'll sit right here next to Jesus.
I thought that's what he had.
Me too.
Of course he did. Of course.
I have been looking forward to this supper with you, with all of my being. It will be the last time we are together before my suffering and death. In truth, I tell you, I will not eat any more until the kingdom of God is fulfilled, nor shall I drink any wine. John, my beloved, will you now ask the questions required of the Passover?
Yes. Why are the foods we eat on this night different from all other nights? On all other nights, we eat bread made with yeast and left to rise. But on this night, it is unleavened.
This is the bread of the affliction, eaten in Egypt. As my father delivered your forefathers from the bondage of Pharaoh, so will I deliver you from the bondage of sin.
And what is the meaning of the Paschal lamb we roast?
The lamb is a symbol of sacrifice. It reminds us of the blood that was spilled and poured out over the doorposts to save the Israelites from the angel of death. God has provided that lamb to be a sacrifice, that by the blood of the lamb, many will be saved from death.
And what is the meaning of the bitter herbs?
The bitter herbs remind us about how the lives of our forefathers were bitter under the bondage of Egypt. The bondage of sin is bitter also. Blessed art thou, O Lord, creator of all these things. Bless them to our use. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Cast one. Cast one.
Been some wonderful things done during that time. Things I never thought to see.
It's true. So, healings and miracles such as no man ever did. Martha and Mary's brother, Lazarus, raised from the dead. Out of the grave, my hero.
The feeding of the 5,000.
That's right. I remember that. Good.
And two fish.
None of it will ever be forgotten.
Here, here. Here. That.
Yes. Yes. That's always the thing.
You need some help. Pass on the keys.
This is the best roast lamb I've had in a long
time. Can you believe that? You and food. Tonight, especially not because of the food, but because of what the master has said.
It's coming.
What was that?
He said he would not eat or drink anything again until the kingdom is fulfilled. Didn't you hear? Tonight must be the night. I have felt something was going to happen. Felt it all week, as a matter of fact.
Well, it is about time he did something after all the trouble he stirred up with the authorities this week.
You're right, but with many soldiers in the city for the festival, do you think it'll be that soon?
I don't know.
Well, the kingdom is very near.
The kingdom is near.
Well, Lord, when your kingdom is set up, will I have a place of honor? A title, perhaps?
Yes, and I should always sit at your right hand.
Has my mother spoken to you? She wanted special places for John and I. Yes.
And Lord, you said that I should be the keeper of the keys.
Why,
that's right. Yes.
Lord, with my experience in government, I would be an asset.
I think we all can take part in it. I mean, we can all work this out.
I think you should sit down. Okay, all right.
Lord, I know we've all spoken out of turn, but we wonder, when will you set up your kingdom?
It troubles me, John. My time here is so short, and you all seem to understand so little. Is there any water here?
Yes.
That's in the back.
The jug in the corner. I can get it.
Okay.
The basin, too?
Yes.
Master, what is it?
doesn't make any sense. He didn't tell me this.
That's right.
Yeah.
John's feet. Oh.
John.
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 What are you doing?
Say something. Pastor, go to wash his feet. Oh, Peter. I did not know about this. Nope. He asked me to prepare the room. This is different.
You tell him.
Yes. I will tell him. Right, I can do that? Yes. Mm-hmm. I got this. I will tell him.
Mm-hmm. There. Now you are clean. Peter, it is your turn.
Peter, just tell him. Lord.
Peter won't let that happen.
You will never wash my feet.
That's right.
That's right.
You are a Lord and Master.
You are.
Not a servant. You will never, never wash my feet.
That's right.
Then you will have no part with me.
What?
Well, Lord, then not just my feet, but my hands and my head also.
Peter, one who is bathed is clean all over and only needs their feet washed from time to time to remain clean. Now you are clean. That is not true of all of you. Judas, you are next.
Breaking through. The dark of night will not overtake me. I am pressing into you. Lord, you fight my every battle. And I will not fear. I am not alone. shelter. You're my refuge in the storm. Through these trials, you've always been faithful. Not alone, you will go before me.
what I have done?
No. What have you done? No.
Strange.
You call me Master and Lord.
Yes.
And that is right, for so I am. But if your Lord is willing to wash your feet, you should be willing to wash each other's feet. I have given you an example, and it is for you to follow.
Can I do that?
Do that.
The servant is not greater than his master, neither is he that is sent to him. I am not speaking to all of you. I know whom I have chosen. But I speak now so that the scriptures may be fulfilled. Truly, I tell you, one of you will betray me.
No, no.
Betray
no.
The master.
No, no,
we would never.
No,
we would never
betray the master.
What's he talking?
Nobody's
saying
that. I wouldn't.
There's more.
Who will it be?
The one to whom I give the bread.
No.
Do what you must. Quickly.
I think that one of them, one of them. Where is Judas going in the middle of the Passover feast?
He must be going to buy something for the master. He is a treasure, after all.
Well, that is true.
Maybe that's it. But still in the middle.
Lord, will you not bless the bread and the cup of wine as it is done? The cup of blessing drunk in freedom from Egypt.
Yes. Blessed art thou, O Lord, God of the universe, the creator and sustainer of life. Thou who hast brought forth the bread that nourishes us from the dead seed planted in the ground. We give thee thanks. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Take, eat. This is my body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
This body broken for you.
Remember.
Blessed art thou, O Lord, God of the universe, the creator and sustainer of life, thou who hast brought forth the vine and its fruit. We give thee thanks. Amen.
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 This cup is my blood of the New Testament, shed for the remission of many sins. Do this in remembrance of me.
Again, remembrance. Is he still? In remembrance of me.
Come. The table is ready.
But you keep standing at a distance in the shadows of your shame. But there's a light of hope that's shining. Won't you come and take your place and bring it all to the table? Nothing he ain't seen before. For all your sin, all your sorrow and your sadness, there's a Savior and he calls. Bring it all to the table. He can see the weight you carry. Fears that hold your heart. But through the cross you've been forgiven. You're accepted as you are. So bring it all to the table. It's nothing he ain't seen before. Your trials, all your worries and your burdens, there's a Savior and he calls. Bring it all to the table. Bring it all. You can bring it all. There's no one who's turned away. All you sinners, all you saints, come right in and find your grace. Come on in, take your place. There's no one who's turned away. All you sinners, all you saints, come right in and find your grace. Bring it all to the table. It's nothing he ain't seen before. For all your sin, all your sorrows and your sadness, there's a Savior and he calls. Bring it all to the table. Thank you.
Now is the Son of Man glorified, and God be glorified in him. If God's glory is revealed through him, then God himself will reveal the glory of the Son of Man. Yet for a little while, I am here with you. Where I am going, you cannot follow. And so I give you a new commandment. Love one another. Even as I have loved you, love one another. By this will all men know that you are my disciples, if you love one another.
Lord, you talk about going away, and we cannot come.
That's right.
Where are you going?
Yeah, where are you going?
Where I am going now, you cannot follow yet. But later you will all follow me.
Of course we would.
I will follow you now. I will give up my life for you.
That's right.
Peter would. Do that.
We all would.
Would you, Peter?
You know that he would, of course.
I tell you, before the rooster has crowed, you will have denied me three times.
No.
Peter would never deny that.
Never. Never would I deny you. Never. If I stand with you,
before
I would not deny in any way.
Before tonight is over, you will all fall from your faith. On my account. For it is written, I will smite the shepherd, and the sheep of his flock will be scattered. But after I am risen, I will go before you into Galilee. Let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. It is time. I will sing the Passover hymn before my suffering. You shall cross the barren desert and you will not die of thirst. You will wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words to foreign men, and they will understand. See the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell and death is at your side,
and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked men insult and hate you, all be
Garden and pray, for my time has come and the hour is near at hand. Come, watch with me.